Good afternoon, everybody. Since morning, we heard a lot of our experts on R&D, all parts, major parts of solar plants, and new R&D, what developments are taking place in solar industry. Luckily, I am also associated with the solar industry from 2011. So, I have seen journey of almost 6 years, good journey of solar, how it is developed from 13, 14 rupees to 244 figures. But O&M cost, if you say, from 7 to 4 or 5, not 2.44. The day you make it 2.44, this plant will not be existing, I tell you. This is a fact. Anyway, because a lot of developments are happening, because a lot of inefficiency in system, which we have seen in 2011, 10, 11, over-designing, optimization, whatever happening is happening very good. So today we are in mature situation in solar, we can say 2.44, 2.4 or 2.5 is going to be not much down, because the some costs are fixed, not only modular inverters. There are many other equipments which are common to all industries, which we are also using. Like land price going up is not going to go down because we are based on our tariff. If tariff is going down, land price will go up certainly, because demand is more. More plants are coming up in rural areas. So that demand is going up, certainly price go up. Our tariff coming down. So everything will not come down ultimately. So we have to see ultimately whatever we are doing. This is optimization and efficiency has to come in system, then only we can survive. What are inefficiency, what we have done in past, transportation time, execution time, 8 months, 9 months, 1 year, more than 1 year sometime, 50% plant made up, 50% not made up, lot of revenue loss. That time we afford because price was 6 rupees, 7 rupees, could have been afforded. But now it's not possible. We have to be very smart, we have to work very smartly on such a way. The day plant commissioning done, like Mytrah has done 51 days in advance. Similar trend work we have to find a way. If we are going beyond that, they have huge penalties. These are being encased by the LED, the, we can say, the government agencies because of delayed projects. Penalties are being imposed. Even PPAs are in danger. So there are a lot of risk involved in this. To overcome all this, first of all planning has to be done. Since morning we have seen all planning was done. Planning, financing, execution, everything done. Now comes O&M part. When anything like work execution, planning fine, everything fine, no, not an issue at all. Major fail, major gap what we see today is work execution, execution quality at the site level. Because a lot of plants are coming up from 1000 megawatt to 500 megawatt to 5000 megawatt in journey in single year. So this is a quantum of the at field level, how many people are working. Are they so much trained to execute this work? Are we training them? Do we have time to train them what to do? We expect so much of things from unskilled person. We assume he will deliver everything for me, what I expect. And he never communicate what I my expectation is very ideal, but he never communicate. This is a gap this between the execution and our expectation. This has to be met together through training, execution, level at site level. Then only we can go ahead and sustain this market. It's very, very good, no doubt. It's a challenging, but not possible. It's a possible, sustainable. If we provide proper material, proper design, as Mamta has told, this Monica has told, we should not compromise on design. Whatever IS standard says, if we compromise on design, we are compromising with our future planning, ultimately. We are compromising with our business, on which our model is standing on that. We should not compromise on that. We should optimize it certainly, no cost reduction, optimization, where extra over design or something has to be curtailed certainly. Manpower has to be skilled. If you cut any cost on O&M certainly, where O&M cost can come? Model cleaning cost, almost optimized. If you go water cleaning or dry cleaning, water process are available, at the capital cost involved. So you have to take a balance which way you have to go. Volume is high, you have to go for robotic cleaning. For robotic cleaning, you have to have proper fine quality of execution, because robotic cleaning will not work on zigzag. Ultimately, this is what we have structures. You go any solar plant, how much undilution they have in land. So that we have to balance ultimately. We have to go manpower or machine. That balancing has to be done. And everything costs money. If you deploy more manpower, more cost will come. But the optimization has to be done ultimately. It's a balance. So that has to be executed, certainly. And what are execution done? From project execution to when project comes to operation part. There is a one process called handing over, taking over. A lot of people are hearing this. But if that process is made effective, I can assure you, your plant will be assured for 25 years, no doubt in this. If that process is robust. the moment plant is completed, it has to be handed over to the developer or owner. So effectively, the water deficiencies build up in the plant is rectified before contractor moves out of the plant. With any deficiency workmanship left in between, 25 are going to suffer with this plant. That has to be tested properly, performance test to be conducted, then only say now my plant is fully operational for operation maintenance activity. O&M can do only O&M, they can't do any design change, they can't do any modification ultimately. Water plant given to the O&M, they can maintain it. So in process, whatever execution is done, now depend on the again developer who is investor, he want to have execution from grade A contractor or any contractor who say I can do less than 1 crore, whatever, least price. Quality has to be seen, who is doing my project, because this is a huge project, 25 megawatt, 50 megawatt, this is a huge investment. To whom we are handing over, just to saving some cost of, some money we are saving, but we are delivering project to whom? What is the reliability of the contractor? There has to be, difference has to be checked. Before the water project he has delivered, how they are performing? Is there any deficiency in design, execution? That has to be reviewed periodically ultimately. We have to learn from our mistake. We should not commit mistake again and again, again and again. Then we are going to collapse our market completely. That we should take care. And whenever, like contractor, when you are finalizing any contractor, this is a very, very basic thing. We say my project has to be completed because a lot of developer has, investor come in the market without much deep knowledge in solar, because solar is newly developed. So work scope not fully defined. EPC contracts are given. Monica may be agree with me. A lot of dispute may be coming. It should have been done, but it was not in contract. Correct? Well, expectations are very high. But expectation comes after 50% project is completed. My expectations are somewhere else. Then there's a difference in gap. Then misunderstanding, mistrust has started. You have not executed this. So something has to be done better. So that need to be taken care of. Work scope, now we are in a matured market. Already we have almost 7-8,000 megawatt commissioned in India for solar. So matured market, we know what to be done, what not to be done. So BOP has to be prepared properly. Work scope has to be defined, breakdown, and complete costing has to be done properly. Even if something required to be paid for APC cost, is a worth to pay for a keeping safe investment of for 25 years. So don't compromise the short term. You may achieve your target for short term execution, but ultimately you are going to suffer for a long time. So don't cut corners on quality and execution. Execution has to be done properly. Design team has done their job. Ultimately execution is a major task. There are a lot of unskilled person, a lot of stakeholders are involved. They are executing our projects. That should be in safe hand. When you are giving good contractor, you can find out some vendors are selection, vendor criteria has to be finalized within a company. Then you can success. If anybody, cost is on one factor which can affect your plant performance, but not all the factors, it's one of the factors. So vendor has to be finalized properly. Like one of our panel morning expert has told that increase of 1% O&M cost will decrease of 1% of IRR. Good correlation, no doubt. But if your O&M is not effective, here at least 1% risk you are taking knowingly. If my good O&M can perform my hardly 1% IR going to affect. If not doing good percent, good O&M, then you can't calculate also how much loss going to be there. So O&M has to be ultimately, everybody is included. Since morning I heard R&D department, production, supply chain, everybody is working together. O&M also has to work smartly. They have to optimize, cut cost, optimize cost, not cut, optimize cost. Correct. So then only we can achieve this joint targets. And this is a possible, nothing impossible. It's all possible targets which we can achieve. But ultimately O&M, this is a cost one threshold where below that if you want to operate, you will not get good person. For example, when 2011-12 when I was operating plant in Charanka plant in Gujarat, solar park, for Lenco Solar, I was heading O&M there. I was keeping for 15 megawatt, 6 engineers, 5-6 technicians. Now I'm keeping for 25 megawatt, 3 engineers, 3-4 technicians. Because automation has taken place, cleaning system has come up, it has come up very well. So we are also optimizing. Correct. Now if you go less than that, if you are compromising more, optimizing more manpower, cutting more manpower means you are going to compromise O&M quality. O&M quality means your frequent breakdown, you can't monitor effectively ultimately. The moment you stop monitoring, you don't know how much plant is not operating. Because in solar nothing is, you can say moving parts other than tracker. If you don't have tracker, then nothing is moving. By extensive plant, whatever generation coming to you, you have to be happy. If you are monitoring very closely, each and every thing has to be monitored, analyzed, and at the end of the day, when your plant is performed, Person has to analyze completely my string wise performance, how it is. Plus minus 5%, fine. If it is more than that, why? My strings are swelling losses are less or more or what? Has to be analyzed, and corrective action has to be taken after sunset to sunrise. This is a maintenance period. People say O&M is very simple for solar. Correct. What is there? Nothing. No moving part, no failure. But I tell you, this is a monitoring and monitoring. The more you monitor, more revenue you get. More monitoring, for monitoring you require a skilled person. You need a skilled person who can monitor your plant. Then you can achieve a performance. I can tell you, Gujarat 2011 to 2014 when I was there, every year, plant performance, actually as per design, 1% degradation should be there every year, as per module degradation, 0.75 to 1% every year, efficiency will come down. 1 megawatt plant becomes after 1 year, 990 kilowatt, correct? But continuous 4 year, all plant has performed 3 to 4% higher. Doesn't matter, because execution what was done, it was improved, its cleaning cycle was optimized, new system was in place. So revenue what was targeted was exceeded the target. And till today plants are performing very good. Because there's the execution quality, people were there, they have taken care very nicely. But now because volume is so much, we are considering only volume, 100 megawatt, 200, 300, 500 megawatt. But if that is not properly monitored, not executed properly, let me assure you, your wire, whatever wire number you are calculating on your softwares or Excel sheets, not going to work. Properly has to be executed, plant properly has to be monitored, validated through the third party inspection, quality inspection has to be done. And handing over, taking over process, what is defined, well defined, between EPC contractor and owner. This has to be implemented. If you are not implementing this, then certainly you are taking great risk for your complete investment. Once you take on the project, plant performance test is done, it is designed for 75%, 77% performance ratio, it is delivered, you say, okay, as per my design, I achieved my results, now plants can be performed better. Then we can maintain it. Without handing over, take over, if you take over some plant, then certainly they go to a huge risk. So this will, I think the new word may be handing over, taking over, because all maybe some financial or technical or business persons are sitting here, business development. But this is basically, this is required, because ultimately you are 1,000 crores of worth of investment. Somebody has executed and owner says, okay, my plant is operational, you can start operating without any handing over and documentation. The only warranty also get void if you are not handing over properly. Warranty will say you are not maintained my inverters or my module as per the design. It's mishandled. It was not tested properly. It was not maintenance, not done properly. So this has to be done properly. Handing over done, this process has to be defined. Already defined, you have to define an organization, how you want to have, how deeply you want. If you don't have expertise, appoint third party contractor, whoever is expert, at least this process has to be completed. And regarding this skill development, because there's a lot of plants are coming up, lot of people are joining, lot of new companies are coming up, people are joining up, freshers are coming up. Every company or every somewhere has to be set up minimum training level for monitoring safety aspect, because 1000 volt DC is very, very dangerous, not safe. Proper equipment has to be used for this test equipment. Generally what happens, we all have, you know, multimeter megger, generally we use it at homes. And industry, I have visited many plants, 90% plants, wearing some 10% only, because we have big IPP, this EPC companies, 90% companies are not using tested multimeter megger. A lot of flashover are happening because of this. Because if you are not using properly multimeter megger, the moment you touch your terminal in the component panel, your multimeter gets short circuit, a panel gets blast. Ultimately, it is interconnected. So the rating defined, everything like design, every defined. But in our India, what happens? These all multimeters, test equipments, they never say any standard. They say multimeter megger. So for our industry, because we are operating 1000 volt, now we have 1500 volt. For 1000 volt, we should have category 3, 1000 volt AC, DC. These are category defined for the multi equipments. Why I am telling you, because a lot of technical people are sitting here, we all have done our engineering from very good institutes, but we never taught what is category 1, category 3. I'll just brief you. Category 1 is 220 volt domestic use multimeter. If you say category 1 CAT1, you can use for only domestic 220 volt supply. Category 2 means 400 volt AC DC you can use. Category 3, it comes on solar and wind, because we are operating wind at 690 volt, solar 1000 volt, 800 volt, 9000 volt, up to 1000 volt maximum till now. In future, we may have 1.5 kilowatt also. So category 3 has to be used. If you are using category 2 multimeter meter or this clamp meter on 1000 volt DC, surely going to be major fatal accident at the site. It is happening. I have seen many places. And in West Art, when we have done root cause analysis, this was the main cause. The multimeter was not proper rated and a lot of fatal accident took place. That has to be taken care by all of us. We all are sitting here. We have all leader position here. This we can pass on to our plants, plant head or O&M, even project execution, EPC also, because a lot of testing are happening. Some people have already taken care. We have to take care. We have to be very safe. We have to be environment friendly. We should not be polluting anything. Ultimately, whatever we are doing, we have to do all our job smartly in such a way whatever inefficiency build up in system has to be wiped off. We can't survive with inefficiencies now because system is very, very efficient. We have to be efficient only to survive this market. Thank you very much. Thank you.